It was on the longest stage of the rally, the 855 kilometres into the Tuareg town of Agadez, that Gaston Raye on the Marlboro BMW finally came good. Raye's ability to combine tricky slow sections like this dried-up riverbed with the flat-out blasts through the open desert helped him to score the team's first stage win of the 1987 Paris-Dakar. He was 10 minutes ahead of his arch-rival, Cyril Niveau. But Serge Baku wasn't having things his own way on the four-cylinder Yamaha. Finding the heavy bike a handful at low speed. On the Italian Cagiva, Hubert Auriol was up to second spot by Agadez. But very soon, the team is embroiled in a cheating scandal, and his two backup men, Alessandro De Petri and Renzo Gualdi, are thrown out of the event for swapping bikes illegally. Claudio Tiruzzi on the Honda Italy bike picks his way carefully through the boulders. Followed by Eddie Orioli, now sixth overall in the bikes. At Agadez, Jeff Hutchinson asked Vatanen about his progress so far.
How has it been for you the last few days?
No, generally it has been very good. I mean, otherwise I wouldn't be in the lead. I've been able to go quite consistently, which is the name of the game here, to avoid the problems and to go non-stop. We have only lost 10-15 minutes a couple of times in navigation, that's all. Otherwise we have avoided the trouble.
What about mechanically? How is the car standing up to this kind of punishment? Have you had any problems at all?
So far so good, very well indeed. We haven't had any problems mechanically, and I really hope it stays that way, and I try to do my best to keep it that way.
This race, of course, or this rally, of course, is very much different to a World Championship rally. You're going for much longer periods of time. How have you modified the car to cope with such a long-distance event?
Well, first of all, we have to have enough fuel. So we have 400 litres in the tanks, and then we have got another 40 litres in the cans if we have to. And suspension is much stronger. The car is a little bit longer to accommodate all the fuel. And engine has been detuned, and well, that's about it, and so far it has turned out to be a good solution.
You were talking earlier about some of the beauty of the desert that you've been through so far. Do you really get time to look at the scenery?
Well, luckily I haven't had too much time. I mean, when you get stuck, then you have got plenty of time to admire the scenery, and I haven't had that much time, but enough to see how beautiful it is, and you realize how small the mankind is there.